never thought we would be asking, who put smallpox virus inside a cardboard box and left it in a storage room? Who came near it and how dangerous was it? ABC's chief medical editor, Dr. Richard Besser, starts us off with answers.
Tonight, real alarm about how 6 vials of smallpox, one of history's most feared viruses, were left in a low-security FDA laboratory for decades, forgotten in a refrigerated storage room at the National Institute of Health in Bethesda, Maryland.
If this material is infectious and these vials had broken, what could have happened?
There is a potential that someone could have contracted the disease.
The vials, believed to be from the 1950s, were discovered 1 week ago when the contents of the storage room were being moved. Opening that box, workers saw an alarming label, Variola. That's smallpox. They quickly moved it to a biohazard level 3 lab, one with cameras, scanners, and alarms, where everyone wears protective gear. The National Security Council was notified, and 5 agencies, including the FBI, worked out a plan to transport the deadly virus safely to the CDC in Atlanta. Late last night, the vials were packed up, escorted to the airport by federal and local police, and flown on a government plane to CDC headquarters. Smallpox, which is highly contagious, killed 2 million people a year as recently as 1967. But it was wholly eradicated after an unprecedented worldwide campaign to get people vaccinated. By international agreement, samples lived on in only 2 labs, the CDC in Atlanta and one in Siberia, or so we thought until today. Law enforcement have long feared what could happen if terrorists get their hands on smallpox and turn it into a weapon. The newly discovered vials are now in a level 4 biohazard lab. Security is so tight, you now need an eye scan to get access. The smallpox discovery comes just weeks after the CDC acknowledged, possibly exposing dozens of lab workers to anthrax, those workers currently being treated with 2 months of antibiotics.
First anthrax, now smallpox. Should we be worried?
In both of these cases, which are unfortunate, CDC's response was swift and deliberate to ensure public safety and to try to get to the root cause of what had happened.
The good news here is these vials were not open, so no one was endangered. And if the virus did get out, thankfully we have vaccine that would have protected anyone who was exposed. But the big question tonight, what other deadly germs could be hidden away in labs around the country?
That's it, Rich. How many of these storage facilities are we talking about, and how on earth do you search them all?
Well, you know, there are hundreds, thousands of laboratories. I think what has to happen is the directors of those labs have to do spring cleaning, go through every freezer, every corner, make sure there's nothing there that shouldn't be there.
Some spring cleaning.
Exactly.
This was a close call. Thank you so much, Richard Besser.